We had activities. We did, you know.
Their names are Sally and Jack.
I notice on here, Bubba.
Sister and brother.
Is your name on in here? Oh, yeah. It is.
And back before the pandemic began, we watched as they sifted through a trunk full of old memories.
I can tell you what it is in Chinese. It's lazi bazo. It's a mess. I feel like I'm a vessel. Okay. And why I'm used is to tell my story.
A story they worry hasn't been told enough. They were born in China to a Chinese woman and her American husband, a soldier who died when they were very young. And by the time Sally turned 11, Jack 13, and their older brother Jimmy was 16, the Japanese invaded China at the start of World War II.
War is hell, so...
Hell that their mother tried to save them from.
Mother was not able to care for the three of us.
By sending them to live with a Christian missionary who took them to the safety of the Philippines.
We thought we were safe because on the American flag.
But the Japanese army was already there.
In 3 months' time, we were in prison camp.
They became among the tens of thousands of civilian prisoners of war.
Really on a starvation diet.
Held with Americans and other non-Japanese in internment camps.
And the Japanese would say that they died of heart attack instead of starvation.
In between the two barbed wire fences called no man's land. If you were caught in the no man's land, the Japanese shot you and then asked questions later.
But the teenagers were among the survivors because after 3 years of captivity, Americans helped liberate them. The same day the American flag was being raised on Iwo Jima.
On February 23rd, 1945.
Thousands of miles away.
My fondest memory is my liberation.
When the soldiers arrived, Sally was hiding in the barracks underneath a bed.
I could saw the paratroopers' boots. That was the most beautiful sight.
They would go on to live full lives here in the United States. Today, Sally is 89, Jack is 92, and in the time they have left...
We need to realize that war doesn't help anything.
They want the world to remember their story, too.
You get through one war, you go to another.
I guess it's maybe it's because that I am so appreciative that I'm living here. I was given the privilege to live in a country that is free. I didn't know till I became elderly that I was part of history. And the story needs to be told.
Told and remembered so that a world wrapped up in its current problems can see what freedom really means.
Sally, you know this one?
Before a trunk full of old memories.
Everything happened to me.
Slowly fade away. In Arlington, I'm Kevin Reese.